Historians and literary critics have noted no other writer has half the chance of being remembered as Edgar Allan Poe. Every year on Poe's birthday, January 19th, for decades now, there has been a mysterious graveyard visitor who visits Poe's gravesite. He leaves behind a bottle of cognac, which was Poe's favorite drink, three red roses, and often a nice handwritten letter. People try to catch a glimpse. Some folks report that the person wears a cloak, or that it appears he's gliding and has no feet, but nobody really knows. I guess the only way to find out would be to take a field trip.
My love for you is never ended, like a waterfall flowing through the rolling hills.
It's like you're some sort of witch who put a spell on me, a spell of love. I've never felt this way about any woman before. My love for you is both that of a father and that of a husband. I can see myself now in the 30 years we'll spend together, long into the future, till we're the old age of 40 or perhaps even 50.
Sweet young cousin, not yet a woman, but still the true love of my heart. Will you, Virginia Clem, take my hand in a lawfully wedded marriage?
Oh yes, Eddie.
What's up, Vlog Squad? It's Brandon out here at the Baltimore Cemetery. We're back here for an update. No toaster yet. I've been waiting for about 45 minutes, and I don't think this guy's gonna show.
I'm getting a little bit tired. I've been out here 5 hours now trying to find this toaster for y'all.
While we're waiting for this toaster, we're gonna do a fit check for y'all. Got the black trench coat, red sweater vest, call me Mr. Rogers. Sweet, sweet button down. The gray corduroys and green Crocs like always. You know how we do it.
I'm beginning to wonder if he's even real.
Is that the toaster? I think that's him. We're waiting for the toaster now. I got a good position down low. I don't think he'll see me coming. What? Who are you?
Brandon, I am here to show you the life of Edgar Allan Poe.
What does that even mean? Where am I? Where'd you take me to? What is this place?
Do not mock Edgar Allan Poe. I need to show you this troubled child.
I couldn't realize he had it so hard. Oh, show me more, dude.
I want food. I am the toaster.
Whatever, man.
Mother, father, I have some great news for y'all before I head off to university in the morning.
What? You finally decided to get a real job, you morbid fool?
John, please. This is our last dinner together before he leaves for university.
Thank you, Mother. Well, Father, if you must know, I've been engaged to a lovely young lady.
What? This is outrageous! I give you all the money you need to go to an education. The best money can buy. And you go and waste on this whore. Father, I I will not stand for the way you treat Sarah. She is the love of my life. Get out of my sight. I hate you.
Hi, honey.
Why didn't you take my side against Edgar?
He's my son.
I don't care. My chicken. Give me it.
Now.
Paper, scissors, when it takes off!
Oh, I'm down for that. I need a drink first.
Deliver. You can't be drinking that.
I don't care. I'm thirsty.
Oh, wait. Give me a swig of that before you put it in.
Gentlemen, I'm feeling quite lucky.
All right, yeah, I'm good. All in.
All in! All in.
Boys, ready?
Let's get this.
You too.
You feeling
good? I take the winner.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Oh, you son of a gun! Oh, I won't stand for this. This is much malarkey.
Want a drink?
Oh. Dearest Edgar, I've written to let you know that I wish to break our engagement. You don't make me happy. I've found a better man.
Stupid harlot, I never loved you anyways. Let's see what daddy you're opening.
Edgar. If you insist on throwing all your money on the card table, then I will stop supplying you with it. I've given you enough to attend a good university, and I will not supply a single cent until next summer. Find someone else to pay off your gambling debts. I have a whole flock of illegitimate kids to support.
I love you too, Father. Women have been angels of mercy while men have sat on the sidelines and watched. Professor Raffelbaum.
Mr. Poe, your behavior has been unacceptable. Your gambling is a disgrace to this university.
Professor, you have to forgive me. I'll pay back my debts. I'll do anything. I need this.
Enough said. Be gone, you talentless drunk.
I have been very happy with your actions over these past several months. You've earned yourself a promotion. Way to go, Major.
Thank you, sir.
General Softbottom.
Yes, Major.
Sir, I have not had complete candor with you. I need to leave the Army.
And why would that be, Major?
Well, sir, I lied. My name is not as it seems. It is Poe. Edgar Allan Poe. I am 17 years of age. I'm not qualified to serve.
Well, why did you run off to the Army then, boy?
Well, sir, I had nowhere else to go. You see, I've been on the run most of my life from all sorts of demons. And now, I've been abandoned yet again, this time by my would-be father and benefactor.
I'll tell you what. You get someone to finish your enlistment.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
You didn't let me finish. I'll need somebody, particularly your father, to write me a letter saying that he'll take you on as his benefactor.
Aye, sir. As soon as I can.
Good day.
Francis! Come give this letter to your stupid son.
Did he finally write?
Now quickly, I want to see what he says back to this. Alright, I'm coming, Toots! What are you doing, Franny?
Nothing.
Come back!
I'm glad to let you go, Poe. Best of luck in your future. What exactly is it that you plan to do?
Well, sir, I plan to go visit my aunt. Maybe take up some riding.
To be blunt, I find that plan foolish and barbaric, but best of luck anyways.
I'll be the first, sir.
Well, hello there, Eddie. Funny seeing you here again. Looks like you brought me another young lady.
Hello, dog.
Eddie, is that you?
Yes, Mom. Yes, it is. I came to see you. How are you doing?
Not so well, my son.
Oh, I don't think she got too much longer, so I get you goodbyes in while you can.
No. Mom!
Your father wanted to speak to you.
Oh, Eddie. Hey, my boy. Please forgive me. I don't think I can go on without your mother being here.
She's passed.
Mom! You killed her! You killed her! I hate you!
Oh, Virginia. Hi, my sweet cousin.
Oh, Eddie! It's been so long!
My dear Tanner, great to see you as always.
Are you staying for dinner, Eddie?
Why, of course I am, darling.
So, Edgar, how long will you be staying with us?
Well, my sweet cousin, I do have to find a job, so I cannot linger long. Perhaps a few fortnights.
Well, you will have a splendid time while you're here.
I'm sure.
It's always great to have you, Edgar.
Thank you, Auntie.
There you go, Virginia.
Is it three?
Perfect! You're the smartest girl in the whole world.
You want to carry the three, Virginia?
Oh, perfect. Perfect. Oh, you're so sweet.
Very good, Virginia. Oh.
Eddie, I don't know how to do this one.
Oh, well, let me show you, sweet cousin. Well, you're going to want to factor this. You know what factoring is, Virginia?
Mm-mm.
Well, let me show you.
Oh, Eddie, come back soon. We'll miss you so.
Yes, Edgar, we love you so. Be safe.
Oh, I'll come back just as soon as I can. Miss y'all.
That'll show him and his lazy, untalented arse. Ooh.
Dear Edgar, I write to you with unfortunate news. In your absence, I've been required to move young Virginia with some distant relatives. I'm sorry, I know you two are inseparable, but I simply can't maintain your sustenance on my own.
Sweet cousin, don't go away from me.
Fall Virginia, my love, my own sweetest sissy, my darling little wifey, think well before you break the heart of your cousin Eddie.
Oh, Eddie, I'm blushing. Please, Mom, let me stay with cousin Eddie.
Oh, I can't do that, but he is so sweet. Only if he comes back.
Yay, I love him!
My love for you is never ending, like a waterfall flowing through the rolling hills.
It's like you're some sort of witch who put a spell on me, a spell of love. I've never felt this way about any woman before. My love for you is both that of a father and that of a husband. I can see myself now in the 30 years we'll spend together, long into the future, till we're the old age of 40 or perhaps even 50.
Sweet young cousin, not yet a woman, but still the true love of my heart. Will you, Virginia Clem, take my hand in a lawfully wedded marriage?
Oh yes, Eddie.
We are gathered here today for the marriage of Virginia Clem and Edgar Allan Poe. Do you have your vows prepared?
Yes, sir.
Proceed.
My dear, sweet cousin, untouched by the long years of the hard-fought world, my soon-to-be wife, my love for you is flowing like a waterfall. I love you more than words can describe.
My beautiful cousin, my love for you will continue now and forever.
Do you, Edgar, take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
And do you, Virginia, take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband?
Oh, yes, I do.
Perfect. You may kiss the bride.
I haven't seen a case this bad since Benjamin Franklin.
Oh, hello, Eddie. Nice of you to join us.
Well, John, sorry to have heard of your condition.
Well, anywho, I just summoned you here to tell you I took you out of my will. And all my money, in mistake, is going to my bastard children.
You know what, John Allen? I'll tell you. I don't need your money. I'll make a net for myself. You never help me. Oh, I hate you.
He's passed.
Oh man, that sip was short and it hit fast.
Virginia, would you like to join me?
Oh yes, Eddie.
Let's play your favorite song, dearest. Ready? One, two, three, four.
I'm so sorry.
Are you all right?
Yes, Eddie, I'm okay.
Oh, Virginia, are you sure? That's quite...
Actually, maybe. Not yet a woman, yet born with consumption.
Oh, no, my sweet lover! Virginia, no!
Oh, Eddie, you can't stay beside me forever. My love, please wake.
Oh, darling, are you all right?
Yes, I am okay.
I'll never leave your side. You know that, right?
Darling, are you all right? My dear.
My sweet cousin. My darling wife. I'm sure you'll pull through. Our love
Our love is so strong, nothing can separate us. No, no! Doctor! Doctor, come quickly!
Well, there he is, my favorite customer. How are you, Eddie? How's the wife?
Oh, my bad. I'm gonna go fetch us a drink.
I can feel the strength leaving my body. I will love you forever, my dearest. I can see the light.
No! 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 Stay away from her! Stay away from her!
It's a bad time to mention I stole this coat.
You killed her! You killed her!
My sweet darling lover, not yet a woman, alone in the hard, frigid world of the great beyond.
Well, the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabelle Lee. And the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabelle Lee.
I'm coming, Virginia! No! Love for you is never ending. Never ending. Never more.
Thank you.
Let's keep her coming.
I think you've had enough, Sam. You don't need to drown your sorrows.
You listen to me, wench. I'll take my business elsewhere. Do you know who I am? Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan
who? Poe, pal.
Never heard the name before. You're not that guy.
You'll see.
Oh, Eddie. Seeing you here, it reminds me of the day I met you. The day your mother died in this very bed. You know, Eddie? Now this reminds me of the time I stole this coat and became a doctor. And after all that time, I had to help you with all your other women folk that came in here and died in this very bed. May I pity you, Eddie, I pity you.
God help my poor soul.
Here you go, Eddie.
Say it in a-